And now, live from Big Dick Danny Dexing's gorgeous Paradise Alley, the most amazing region in Second Life, Big Dick Danny Productions, in conjunction with Cole Media and Tremendous Travis Entertainment Incorporated, presents the 2015 season of The Hello Show, featuring the infamous Hello Show panel, including Devlin Kas, Seth Cybertar, manning the Ion Second Life News Desk, Drew Harcourt, our very special guest, Swallo Manimbo, special musical guest, Ham Sandwich, and hidden in from view like he should be, our resident Latin lover and Hello Show cameraman, Codemax Wycliffe. And of course, the 12-time SL Talk Show Host of the Year and current YouTube sensation, the one, the only, the wonder from down under, Paul Chaplynski. So now, let's all say hello!
Hello, 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 hello. You know it's good to see you again. To be back with my friends, where the work's not hard, and the century is closing down. I'm not sure what we got. We really don't need a lot. Hello.
People, and I hope you all had a wonderful weekend. Well, it's Monday for me right now. Isn't the year going super, super fast? It's crazy.
Super.
Goodness me.
Super, yeah. super fast. Super fast.
Mm-hmm. I'd like to remind everybody.
Went fast.
What's that? Yes,
super fast. My weekends go really fast.
Oh, that's great. I'd like to remind everybody to get your Paradise Alley Mr. Universe pitches in to Devlin Kas. Devlin, how many thousands of pitches have we got in so far?
Just 1,000.
Oh my god, people, yeah. That one person could win.
Yeah, well, it would suck if he actually loses.
Well, yes, but he could lose if he's ugly. So yeah. Get your pitches in, people, because you could win. Okay.
Satan, you could be Mr. Paradise Alley.
Yes, you could, Satan. And you will be crowned here on the Hello Show studio floor. And you will receive a crown and a scepter and a little robe, everything. It'll be amazing.
And a welcome, Matt, since you're going to be on the floor.
Yeah. That was actually good, Seth.
Huh? I suppose it was.
I suppose.
Oh, a special Olympic announcement, people. That's right, an Olympic announcement. Next week, people, we are having a huge, shut up, a huge James Bond show, people.
You mean fat James Bond, or it's going to be a big show?
No, it's going to be an amazing James Bond theme show. It's going to be amazing, people. Uh-huh. And we want audience participation. So everybody come as a James Bond character, like... In, you know, you could come as a female bad person or some bullshit. I don't know. You
come as brains. Pussy Galore.
Yeah, come as Pussy Galore. You could come as Maud Adams as Octopussy. She was gorgeous.
Octopussy. Miss Moneypenny.
Yes. You could come as, what was that black one's name, the model? Mayday. You could come as Mayday. What was her name? Devlin.
Mayday.
I'm out of my depths in that one, Paul.
No, she was a black model.
Grace Jones.
That's it, Drew. Grace Jones.
Well, that was actually Brewer.
Oh, thank you, Brewer. Yes, Grace Jones was Maud Adams, was Mayday in James Bond movie. She was amazing. She
Paul, really I'll be good. Disappointed if you don't come as Jaws.
Uh-huh.
I'm back in her life.
Very special guest singer.
He died.
Singing one of the James Bond theme songs next week, won't they, Swallo?
Yes, there'll be special James Bond theme song trivia for lots of Lindens.
And a special superstar will be singing one of the songs. Well, we can't tell you any more, people, until next week. So get dressed up and you could win a... For best dressed up as James Bond character.
Can't tell you anymore because we pretty much told you everything.
Anyway, no. That was a special announcement. Close your mind. A special audience. announcement music. It was amazing. Stand by, people. We have a breaking news story here from our own show. We're now on the spot.
Well, Paul, some women in Germany, they like to augment and augment and augment and augment. This special Paradise Alley action news update will include a video, well, not video, but a photo clip at the end. A German model is pounding her chest with pride. She claims she has the world's largest augmented breasts.
Oh
my God. Myra Hills, which doesn't actually sound very German, 27, who models under the name Beshine, claims to have size 32Z breasts on her 5'6" frame. But it's hard to believe that all of her measurements add up. Hills lists her weight as 130 pounds on her website, but that may not be completely accurate, considering each breast contains 10,000 cc's of saline.
Oh my God.
Each breast must then weigh approximately 20 pounds. This is the equivalent to the weight of a toddler. Why they chose a toddler as their weight equivalent, I have no idea.
A 40-pound toddler?
Yeah, no, 20 pounds. Yeah. It is also the weight of a car tire or four large rainbow trout, which is another interesting choice for a weight equivalent.
What?
Yep, exactly. The fact alone raises a few flags about Miss Beshine's story's authenticity. As we remember all too well what happened the last time someone tried to make me look like a boob, Mills' website says her chest comes in at 72 pounds, or more than half her body weight. This, in fact, does not really add up, but I digress. She started as a 32A cup before her first boob job. I just wanted to have bigger and bigger boobs, and the booby greed monster in me never stopped being greedy and hungry. Imagine that sentence in German. So some time ago, when I reached a certain size, I cracked myself up. When I reached a certain size, fans from all over the world started to tell me that I have the largest augmented boobs ever. That's cool and sounds interesting. And it seems that I have reached a milestone in my life. But for me, the most important thing is that I follow my inner voice, which is apparently buried under 72 pounds of breast, and I currently have not reached my goal. They're going to get bigger, people. My fans know what that means.
Mm-hmm.
Hills says her implants can expand further if she desires. However, life is not easy with measurements of 59, 28, 36, as Satan can tell you. Although she can buy pants and shorts off the rack, bras must be made to order, and tops must either be very big and wide or narrow and very elastic. This is a problem our own special guest star, Swallo Manimbo, also deals with. Tight spaces like cars, elevators, and movie seats pose additional challenges. And of course, it is hard to put on shoes or shave your legs if you do not see your own feet. Right, Swallo? Sleeping on my stomach is no longer possible. And on my back, too, because of the weight. So sleeping a bit sideways is comfortable. Even with all of Mills' plastic surgery, there's a woman with a more robust, natural physique, according to the Guinness World Records. That would be Annie Hawkins-Turner. 52, a.k.a., I don't know why these people all have alternate names, Norma Stitz of Atlanta. Her breast size is said to be 102ZZZ, or triple Z. And that is your first Paradise Alley Action News update. Paradise Alley Action News and all of its updates are brought to you by Cold Entertainment Incorporated. We film it, you do it, people like it, see it on YouTube. And here you go in local chat. Is the link if you want to see Mrs. Beshine's behemoth boobages.
Thank you very much. That was Drew Hardcore, our on-the-spot reporter, here live at the Hello Show, where everything happens, kids. Stay tuned for more breaking news. And now, kitty cats, let's hear those big applause for Marketplace Shopping with Seth. Oh my god, it's Seth! Yay, take it away, Seth!
Hello, Dan.
It's you!
It's early in the day.
It's you, little one.
Welcome, one and all, to Marketplace Shopping with Seth, where you can find shit on your own and Marketplace where I can help. So listen up, fuckers. First item is... Cyclops Head. Yeah. Cyclops Head is, like, kind of crazy, kind of cool, kind of freaky. It's one piece. 700 lindens. It's copy mod, no transfer, 100% mesh. And there are 8 reviews with 4 stars.
Oh my god, Swallow, that's not nearly as hot as the Cyclops that I had sex with and got impregnated by.
Oh my god.
Not at all. Your Cyclops was hot, Drew.
Way hotter.
And Oslo has crashed. Let's hear it for Oslo crashing. Yay!
We got one number two. Not poop number two, but item number two. It's a rabbit mesh avatar. Kind of freaky, kind of like a creepy Alice in Wonderland spook fest looking thing. 250 linden. It is
not bad.
Complete. Modify and transfer, but not copy. 0 reviews. And it is, I don't know, kind of creepy. It's only 250 linden, though, so it's not too bad. I'd give it a try if you're looking for something like that.
Oh yeah.
So, we know what got coming up next holiday, Valentine's Day. So, prepare a little sushi with your Valentine. Ooh. It's a Valentine's
Day for sushi. You.
Love sushi tray. It is copyable, no modify, no transfer.
Copyable.
4 prim, 100% mesh, and 99 linden.
Well, if they're eating sushi, Seth, that means I don't have to douche, doesn't it?
Exactly. There's some other things right below that that are also, like, Valentine-related, but we'll get more into that maybe next time.
It is Valentine's Day soon, isn't it?
It's coming up, February 14th. They try and have it on that day every year. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Next item is a mesh donut platter. In case you have a lot of hungry people at your house or you want to start a donut shop, it's only 125 linden. It's the H. Holmes mesh donut. Donut and donut platter mixed.
Push control and then enter when you put those links in. The links, please.
Is anybody in third row? Move up.
Does anybody not see the links?
Theo's on the balcony. Theo's on the balcony. Casey, somebody take a head plant onto the stage.
History shoutingly.
25 linden, it's copy, no mod, no transfer, 7 prim count, partial mesh. It has 12 mixed donuts. They spelled donuts, donut, and doughnut also, just so that nobody could say they did it wrong. But donut is traditionally spelled both ways here in the United States.
Florida.
We'll try that one again. Yeah, there.
Good shouting. See, that's what you got to do, kids.
Yeah.
Shout all words, please, Drew.
Shout all words. Oh, crap. So anyway, the donut platter's pretty cool. If you're having a lunch, big group of people coming over and having a little bit of a...
Yes,
a meeting. Okay.
Definitely.
All right, here's your last item of the day. It is a little backpack monkey. It's a little back monkey. He hangs out on your back. Beautiful. Beautiful. Lovable. Adorable. It's 9 minutes.
Very racist, isn't it, Danny?
1 review with 5 stars. It's copy mod, no transfer.
It is.
Mm-mm-mm.
Seth, can I request?
That's all it does. You can request anything you want.
Seth is scared of
me.
The what?
The flying monkeys from Wizard of Oz. I'm gonna buy one.
Oh. I don't know if they have those.
I'm gonna get one
out for you.
Part.
Okay. So anyway, that's it for Shopping with Seth. I've been taking that.
Oh my god, that was amazing. Let's hear it from Marketplace Shopping with Seth, people.
Ask away.
Do you think that next week? Do you think that next week, since we have the special James Bond theme, Seth will have marketplace items that work around the James Bond theme?
Oh hell no.
That's a good idea.
I think we'll do Easter next.
Seth will do that, little Drew. Because next week, people, it's all James Bond. Goldfinger. Oh, not too much of that, people. Pink. Can't give it away. Okay, let's give it up now for the one and only Devlin Kas with Cooking with Devlin. Hey, clapping by Drew.
That's some gay clapping. Hey!
Do you like that clap, Paul? I think I'm going to incorporate that into the show.
That's gorgeous.
This is donuts you're making?
No, nigga, this is... I don't know what the fuck this
talking.
Is, okay?
Oh, oh my god, this is Paul. I don't say that about Satan. I kind of did too.
Put him a little bit, okay? Look at the damn fool. I don't know what the fuck this is, okay?
This is dry parsley.
This is parsley, dry parsley, okay? You see that shit right here? This motherfucker make any motherfucker thing taste good, okay? Make sure you...
God, Paul, throw yourself.
Oh my god. You already said that.
God. Anyway, we had the ingredient of squid. I don't know whose idea it was, but it became squid. So I found, and I got yelled at, I told it couldn't be calamari, so I found something that was...
No calamari!
It was, I have found you, Italian stuffed squid. And everyone's looking like, what the hell? But okay. What you do need it? Stuff your squid, Drew, and you'll like it.
Oh my god.
We have...
I splattered my ink all over you, Devlin.
Anyway, let's call it my segment, thank you. But we do need ingredients of 6 medium squids.
Ink. Ingredients, get it? Ink?
Ingredients,
very good,
yeah.
Paul. Ingredients.
Thank you very much, Drew. Thank you, everybody.
That's why Paul is the pun master. Paul Chaplynski, pun master. Anyway, you do need a 1/4 cup of Italian-style breadcrumbs. Mm-hmm. 2 tablespoons of fresh parsley leaves.
Paul, did you just screw yourself?
I caught that, by the way, Devlin. That was your first Devlin is trying seriously to cut down on his mm-hmm's. So you need 2 teaspoons of fresh Parmesan cheese, 2 teaspoons of minced garlic.
I love Parmesan cheese, don't we, Seth?
1 egg, salt and pepper. Shut the fuck up, Danny. Then you also need another 2 garlic cloves, a 8-ounce can of diced tomatoes, 1 teaspoon of basil, 1/2 teaspoon of ground oregano, 1/2 teaspoon of ground rosemary, 1/4 cup of green pepper, and 1/4 cup of dry white wine, which you can get from Satan. And then the lovely directions to cook this is clean your squid and pat it dry.
Rubber ducky, you're the one. Oh, not in the bathtub.
You make my time so much fun.
Really, fucking Seth, really.
Donuts. Get yourself a donut and eat it on the floor.
I hate you all. Anyway, what you do need, if you're using your whole squid, you need to chop the tender parts of and off of the tentacles to help.
Now, which part of the squid would be tender?
Chop the tender parts of the tentacles.
Which part of the tentacles?
I don't know, the fucking tender.
The middle.
The tender part. I don't know. I don't eat fucking squid.
The tender part of the squid would be its brain up that top, wouldn't it?
I don't know. Can I continue?
They have very sharp coral teeth.
Jesus Christ.
Sorry, Devlin.
Anyway.
I know what, I'll contain them all.
Yeah, smack
them all. Y'all just shut up and let Devlin read his recipe.
Yeah.
So did you just headbutt yourself? Hello, everybody.
Anyway, I just have to talk over these whores. So after you chop up your tentacles, you mix them with the breadcrumbs, parsley, cheese, and 1.5 teaspoons of minced garlic, your egg, and your 1 teaspoon of vegetable oil to make the stuffing. I didn't even know any vegetable oil, but apparently I did, and it wasn't in ingredients, but there you go.
Now, what sort of stuffing would you use to stuff a squid?
That's what you're making, is a stuffing. That was to make the stuffing to put in the squid.
Oh, is it? Oh.
Devlin, I'm following along at home. I'm writing this down.
Now, that doesn't make sense. How could you stuff the squid with stuffing if you're using the squid for stuffing?
No, it's stuffed squid. The squid is being stuffed like a turkey, except
so
it's got
tentacles. So you have two squids then. There's two squids then.
No, you're not putting a squid inside of a squid.
That would
be like
your
squid.
Devlin, I apologize for Paul on this.
Oh my god.
Just go
you're
with it,
you're using the squid for stuffing, therefore you're using the squid to make the stuffing.
You're using the whole squid, but your only part you're putting in the stuffing is the tender part of the tentacles.
The little bits you don't want to use.
Yeah, the whole like squid cavity part is what you're stuffing.
Squid cavity! That's what it's like technical term, people. The squid cavity.
Squid instead of a pepper.
There's another thing. Thank you, Drew, for that. Now, on a chalk, you stick the stuffing up its ass, but where do you stick it in a squid?
The bottom of it.
Underneath, where all the legs separate.
Yeah, where the legs come out.
Yeah. Cold, I hope
everything,
you're getting all
everyone
this.
Everyone has a hole, Paul.
Okay, well, I'm going to continue, because I'm only at number 3, and I have 8 parts to read, and you keep stopping me.
You're breaking up really bad.
No,
not for me.
This is you. Anyway, after you stuff your squid...
Maybe you should go to Marketplace and buy a new headset.
Yes.
Oh my god, that was mean. Sorry, Seth. I said I was sorry.
Anyway, after you make your stuffing, you blend it well and you add your salt and pepper to taste. Spoon the stuffing mixture loosely into each squid tube, which is the cavity, and close it with a toothpick. Do not overstuff, because the squid will shrink during cooking.
Oh my god.
Would it explode?
No, it will shrink, and I guess it will explode. I don't have a clue.
Oh no, exploding shrimp.
Then add your remaining oil to a large skillet, and that will, I guess, hold all your squids in a single layer. I about burped and I caught it. Anyway, then you heat up your oil and cook your sliced garlic until it's golden brown. Arrange the squid in the oil and brown all sides lightly. Then you add your tomatoes, basil, oregano, rosemary, green pepper, and the remaining minced garlic, your wine, your salt, and pepper to taste, and cover it tightly and cook for 25 to 30 minutes. Then you remove your toothpicks from the squid and serve whole or sliced along with
pasta. Yes, that leaves the toothpicks in the squid, for God's sake.
Yeah, you take
the
toothpicks out.
Everything else is in the squid.
That's very true. That is...
Yeah, now, Deborah, thank you very much for that, Drew, again. Do you have to squeeze out the black stuff, or what?
Well, when you buy squid in the thing, most of the time the ink thing isn't...
Yeah, it's de-inked.
It's de-inked.
Oh, well, that's good.
Yeah, Devlin, we have crust to say mm-hmm.
No, that's nice. It's not happening. I made it through without it.
Oh, he shouted that. That was very good, Devlin. Thank you.
Now, I do need an ingredient for next this week.
That would be James Bond theme, yeah. Which you should have saved the squid Bond for next week, and you could have called it Octopussy, but anyways.
Well, we could do a cocktail, Drew, for next week.
That is very
that would
smart.
Be wonderful.
You need a martini recipe, Devlin. Very smart.
Yes.
Awesome idea.
Yeah. So, there we go.
Well, there, Amy suggests a caramel martini shaken, not stuff.
Amy, you're amazing. Let's hear it for the gorgeous Amy.
I wrote that down. It is on the list for next week. There we go.
Did you get your crayon out, did you? That's wonderful.
Nope. I used a
borrow. Oh my god, Paul!
No, see, Paul no. I used a borrow, Paul. I'm very sorry.
Oh, that's good.
Pyro.
Whatever.
Thank you, everyone. That was Cooking with Devlin, people. And we're having a caramel martini tomorrow. Next week. Thank you.
This is the way to
Danny Dexing, the owner of Paradise Alley. Hello, Danny.
I'm eating peanut butter. Hello.
That's great. Now, Danny, since you've moved to the Poconos, how have you found the change?
Well, I'm much more worried about shrinkage because it's very cold.
Oh, Paul, I have something to add here.
Yes, Drew.
They had a map of... You know what? Let me... Talk amongst yourselves. I'm going to try and find this really quick.
Well, I was watching Mogwives the other week, and on one of the episodes, they went to the Poconos. It's all bush and...
Keep talking, Paul.
It's all pretty shitty, but it looks
yeah,
quite nice.
Yeah, they had
nice
them over for cocktails. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and they went to this pub, Danny. I can't remember what the pub was called. It looked okay, I suppose.
Danny's place.
Yeah, it's Seth, have you ever been to the Poconos?
No.
I've been there lots of times, Paul, as a tourist.
Oh, did you like it?
Not a dig.
I've been going there my whole life.
Oh, amazing.
In the winter, there's really good skiing and like lodgy kind of places where you can sit around and drink hot things in front of roaring fires and outdoor hot tubs, which are, if they're sanitary, they're fun.
Oh my god,
in the summer,
amazing.
You can do like, they have like nature walks and there's lakes and it's like any other kind of mountainous place. You can have cabins in the woods. And it's very pretty.
Well, Swallo, in the summer, you can go ride Danny's dick as a tourist attraction.
We do have those big water parks and shit. It's cool.
You got a water park?
Yeah, there's water parks there too.
A few other
ones. Well, is that why, like, with four farmers squirting a hose or what? I don't know what it's saying.
They go down the side of a mountain. You can build it's like a natural landscape for a water slide since it's all mountainous. They're pretty large.
Kids get scared and pee in the water. It's really great.
Yeah.
Well, Paul, I can't find this map, but there's a map of the United States with little.
Did you hear that, people?
Yeah, found a map of the United States.
There's a special map of the United States with a picture, not a picture, but like what food is uniquely popular to that state. And so, you know, like in Montana they had steak, and in Texas they had Tex-Mex. Guess what they had in West Virginia?
What, Drew?
Hot dogs.
I would have guessed squirrel.
Hot dogs. Hot dogs are the unique food item of West Virginia.
No possum.
That's kind of true. And what's the staple diet in the Poconos, Danny?
Hot dogs. He lives in West Virginia.
Oh, is it?
No, I live in Pennsylvania. What are you talking about?
No, we send cheesesteaks up there.
Oh, I thought it was Poconos were in West Virginia.
There's a recipe for hot dog soup, you know.
Did you really just say that?
Don't the Poconos go through West Virginia?
No, oh my god.
No, it's part of the contiguous mountain range, though.
Yeah,
that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, please, Drew, do me a New York all the way down.
I have a cold, so nothing I say can be held against me.
Drew, do me a favor and just face palm yourself, please.
Mm-hmm.
West Virginia, I'm so insulted.
Drew, you're amazing. I listen to them.
West Virginia. Thank you, Paul. I am actually on a lot of cold medication right now.
Yeah, what are we up?
That's why I sound like Oslo.
Oh my God,
you're crushing up and snorting OxyContin, not cold medicine.
Well, that's what I learned in West Virginia. That's why they like hot dogs, because that's a delicacy.
Well,
maybe right.
Well, thank you very much for that gripping conversation, Danny. It was amazing. And now, people, like Seth does every morning when he stands in front of the mirror naked, is he hot or is he not? It's time for Is He Hot or Is He Not with Drew. Take away, Drew! Oh my God! Hey, Danny.
Should you stop being another junkie porn star?
My shirt's so sexy. It hurts.
Okay, I'm just warning you people, I feel a sneeze coming on, so it might happen in the middle of Is He Hot or Is He Not. I'm not as talented as you. I don't withhold things. In honor of what's next week's theme show, Paul?
James Bond, Drew.
I have Is He Hot or Is He Not? Let's go over the rules before we explain that. Of course, just
rules.
You just type in Y or N. No need to type it out. No, that's, three letters is a lot for some of you people. Danny will misspell yes.
Shout when you show
so
the
just shout, out Y or N or H or N. Oh, by the way, Danny, my rent is one due over. My rent is one day overdue.
Oh my God,
I just got that
notice. I just got that notice
in my little local chat. Hey. So that's fantastic. Yep.
Deadbeat.
Mm-hmm. I'm surprised, I'm surprised Paul hasn't been up on the rental mountain warning me that my rent is a day. Yeah, you forgot to check everybody else's rent box. I have no idea. I really have a cold, and I'm so fucked up on cold medication right now. Anyways, in honor of James Bond, our hot or not this week is the new James Bond.
Oh, there's a new
one. Yep, Jai Courtney. Oh, and guess where he's from, Paul?
Australia.
Yes, Jai Courtney is from Australia. And let's all vote on whether he's hot.
I like the other one. They have beautiful blue eyes.
Let's vote on whether Jai Courtney is hot or not.
Let's look at this guy. He's the new James Bond, people.
James Bond. It's a very young, kind of hard-muscled chisley. I've been working out in a warehouse, beaten off.
Oh my God, he's gorgeous.
I don't need to use a gun, so I'll just fuck you up with my muscles.
Look at those big hands, Drew.
Yeah, so far we have, hot with a H-double-W-T. Danny says not, because he doesn't like white people. Devlin says, Oslo says Scott, which doesn't make any sense. He is definitely hot. I don't know how Danny, there is no way that if that guy was on your five people Poconos grinder, that you would not go and do him.
He got a funny nose.
Well, yeah, after the three sheeps and a goat that are on there, I had
it
down.
Drew's got a nose like that.
I think if you are looking at his nose, you are missing the point, is what I think. He is definitely hot. I am discarding Danny's vote, and we are calling it unanimous that Jai Courtney is, in fact, hot.
And he'll be the new James Bond, apparently, people. I didn't know nothing about that. How did you know that?
Oh, my shirt.
Yeah.
Research?
Did he?
It hurts.
Drew, did you research that?
Yes, I researched.
Tiger Beat.
I research. Yes, in Tiger Beat. I research all my hot or nots.
I didn't know, even know there was a new James Bond. What happened to the old one?
I don't know if he's actually going to perform in the next James Bond movie. It didn't say he was doing the next movie. It said he is the next James Bond. He's already been tabbed as the next James Bond. So it might be like maybe What's-His-Face is doing two or three more James Bond movies before he will take over, but he has been tabbed as the next James Bond.
I'm Paul.
I'm very excited. Yes, Devlin?
You have seen him naked before.
Yep. I knew Devlin would find this.
Mm-hmm. He was in... that's my second... Mm-hmm, Drew. Third one right there.
We'll see that. Mm-hmm.
He was in Spartacus.
Yes, he is Verga, or which, what term, Farzan? He is the blonde curly. I put a wig on him. He's the blonde curly hair guy.
One. The first one died.
No, he wasn't Spartacus. He was in Spartacus.
He's Spartacus' best friend, isn't he?
Yeah, he's the blonde one that gets killed.
The blonde
they had to fight
killed.
And he has to kill him.
Oh my god, the really gorgeous one.
Uh-huh, yep. With the hot body that we said there, and we said, oh my god, I would do that guy. Why are they killing him?
He was naked in it?
Yep.
Oh my god.
He was naked.
Backshot
naked.
There you go. I just posted the picture of him.
Yeah, backshot naked.
Yeah, that hair is really creepy on him. The nose doesn't look the same.
Oh my god, he looks gorgeous as a blonde.
He does, except we gotta get that chick's legs out of there.
Like
but his ass,
look at that
follow
ass
them.
Yeah, what about the other guy watching?
The other guy watching him is actually hot, too. No, the other guy is pissed at him.
The other guy's hot, but the other guy's dead, too.
Yep, the other guy's dead, too. They're all dead. All the hot guys die, and they keep all the ugly guys on Spartacus.
That's amazing. Thank you very much for that, Devlin and Drew. And there we go for Hot or Not. Oh, my God, it was amazing.
Hot or Not for Week 3, 2015, by Courtney, is now hot.
And let's keep that massive applause coming for the super special guest of the show, the one and only, what the fuck, Swallo Manimbo.
Thank you, Paul. I've had
thank
a busy, crazy week here.
Uh-huh.
And, well, it started off bad because I got a $500 parking ticket, which I am contesting.
God.
So, I took photographs.
That's going to be $500.
I'll show you the picture. Actually, it was two parking tickets. This is bullshit. So, like, I went to 7-Eleven on my way to go jet skiing, and they gave me a ticket for this.
Could
that ridiculous
be.
Or what?
It is. That's a big 7-Eleven.
Yeah. Wow. That 7-Eleven serves a lot of handicapped people, doesn't it?
Apparently.
Did you notice how those handicap spaces are actually away from the entrance of the store?
Well, that's what I thought. I parked on the side, not in the front.
That's
stupid. I was just running into
placement.
Coffee, for Christ's sake. Anyway, but I did have good news. As you might know, I'm training to be a truck driver.
Yes.
And I didn't think it would be, like, all this involved, but they, like, make you go to school. But... so on my first day, they were like, huh, you know, do you think you can park one of these? I was like, oh, yeah, of course. So they actually made a video of me parking on this is my very first day at truck driving school.
Oh,
I can't wait to see this.
Look at these people.
That is awesome.
First time in a truck.
Wow. That is impressive, Swallo.
Uh-huh.
You see, I'm
a natural born truck driver. Don't you see me
That's
as a truck
amazing.
Driver?
That is like fluid without any pausingness or anything.
Well, they're actually doing that fast, not just sped up, because you can see the dirt skidding away from the front wheels as he goes around in that circle, right?
Yep.
Well, it might be the same way, but right there.
That is amazing.
Now let me spit up, Seth.
No, look at how they put the pole on the like the bar on. That's like normal
speed.
You
can see
it in like
some of it
way
out
there.
Some of it's not.
I don't think so. I think it's just time lapse. It's not a. It's like a low frame per video rate.
I vote H. It's hot.
Thank you, Seth.
That is kind of hot.
That is amazing.
I think you actually just turned on Brewer, Swallo.
I've been trying for months.
He saw how you parked, and he's now in love.
See?
Goodness. Hey.
I knew something would work.
You did.
So then, I went out to San Francisco, and this is we may or may not have to have words with Satan about this, because there was a major problem while I was there. They actually had to shut down the escalators at, like, one of the huge BART stops because it was clogged with human feces.
Oh, yeah.
BART is very rapid transit.
I hope there's a picture
there
of that.
There was so much human feces stuck in the escalator, it actually made it stop working.
I don't
because
really want to look at that.
So many people shit on the escalators in San Francisco. So, well, Satan, did you have a little accident? Why were there?
It's Satan.
Perhaps.
I have a question about those pictures. Why is there a random guy holding a kitty stroller with no kitty in it?
Well, I don't know, Drew. We'll have to have sent a special investigative team out, maybe.
His dog jumped out.
Oh. Wow. His papito! His papito!
I like that they have a back-in-service date when they will have the feces removed. That's nice, too.
They had to call hazmat teams out, so I always thought it was a very cool city, but not if people, like, shit on escalators. That's bizarre.
It's very weird. Unless it was rat from underneath the
escalator. No. It was human. That was the determination they made, that it wasn't made by any animal. No stray dogs, no rodents.
Well,
it was
could have been
human
kids.
Waste.
Little children are, in fact, human.
Yeah. Could have pooed in their nappies or something, Drew.
I thought Philly was bad, but that's gross. Even we don't have shit-clogged escalators.
Well, what do you think, Seth? You're the expert on shit, because you deal with it every day. Don't you, Seth?
I wear special clothing for that, though.
He wears special clothing, people. Mm-hmm. And do you put Vicks under your nose?
It depends.
That's for corpses.
Mm-hmm. You use it for any of the burly bad houses you have to go into.
Yeah.
The idea is that it doesn't keep the germs out. You use a mask for that, but it just keeps the smell away.
Crazy.
Well, and Californians are very strange about their bodily functions that way, too, because I remember the last time I was there, I got totally yelled at for flushing urine. I didn't know you weren't supposed to flush. Well, I know, and then everybody goes around saying, if it's yellow, let it mellow. If it's brown, flush it down. I'm like, I just took like a wicked piss. I'm not going to like just let it sit here. I don't know you people. I'm in somebody else's house. Do you want some stranger's piss in your toilet? They didn't seem to care.
Just tell them you squat and you poop just a little bit.
Anyway.
Yeah.
But I did have a very positive experience while I was in San Francisco.
That?
Did you know that you can get your mangina or your vagina high? Yes, you can. There's a new product on the market, and it's made with marijuana, and it actually it's a lube, and it just makes that part of your body stoned.
Oh, I love their website. It's very beautiful.
Yes, it's called Furia. And
yes! Go ahead, sorry, Swallo.
That's okay. I've done extensive research, and most users say that they liken it to the feeling, like, if you do, like, a bong hit or something, that, like, when you first feel the sensation, but it's usually, like, if you smoke it, obviously, it's in your head, but this, actually, you feel that way down wherever you put the lube. So everyone should try this. And, but you can only buy it if you live in Colorado or California, apparently, because there's this stupid law thing or something. But,
I don't.
So keep, if you're ever there, make sure when you go fuck, use this stuff, Danny.
Their website is like a spa website that you open the second page and there's hands and water. It's very beautiful.
Uh-huh. That's to represent the vagina.
Or mangina, Seth. Don't be sexist.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. They show the woman, if you watch the video, writhing around, gripping onto the sheets about ready to rip him into shreds.
That
is
awesome.
Is this true? Brewer's from California.
I know. I'm sure he's into it. Maybe he'd like to try some on me later.
Well, now that he knows you brew, he certainly will.
Over there. I'm going through his nightstand. Anyway, that was my week, Paul.
Thank you very much. That was the gorgeous Swallo Manimbo with What's the Fuck.
And thank you for allowing me to be your special guest star again this week.
You should be our special guest next week, too. Gorgeous. Let's hear it for Swallo Manimbo, people. Stand by, people. We have a breaking news story here at the Hollo Show with our on-the-spot reporter, Drew Harcourt. What's happening?
Well, Paul, apparently in Philadelphia, they are having rashes of flash freezing ice that is causing major accidents and traffic jams, which is going to keep our good friend Danny Dexing and and the director of the Ham Sandwich Dancing Quartet from going into Philadelphia. Flash freezing, Theo, occurs when, and Swallo can confirm this, when you have temperatures of like 32 to 34, and then rain or light sleet, and then it suddenly drops to like 27 or 28, causing flash freezing, and then people skid on. And what did we decide it was going to be called? Not black ice. African American ice. Exactly.
Honey brew.
And that is Paradise Alley Action News Update. Additional segment. Not warranted and not needed. But Paul can't count.
You did three, stupid Paul. Thank you very much. That was Drew Hardcore. I'm here at the Hollo Show. Lovely. And now, people, it's Crazy Signs with Drew. Let's hear it for Drew with Crazy Signs.
People, I'm going to plow through these, as well as plow through Seth's weird random noises that he's now making on mic.
We're supposed to stick to 60 minutes, but
fuck that, Colt. The first of our crazy signs is, I didn't realize this was a big problem, but apparently is. I don't know if it's a problem in your neighborhood, but don't do it. Because it cost you apparently $750 or 90 days in jail.
Mm-mm. Puppy cats.
And this next one is a great advertisement, and it applies to everybody but Swallo. Because if they had to, in fact, keep this for Swallo or Danny, or Devlin, actually. I guess it applies to a lot of people. But if they had to, in fact, keep this promise, they would probably go out of business.
No, don't, Drew.
Nachos as big as your ass!
Well, they do have free wireless internet.
And I wish I had this sign in my store because it would make my day much more peaceful.
Lovely.
This one takes a little reading, But it is well worth it, so I'll give you a few seconds. Because, you know, in case we do, in fact, suffer an atomic, or I'm sure nuclear also applies, attack, all right? This is some very good advice, and you might want to take a look at this on how to protect yourself. I'm going to read it with you. Before the atom bomb burst, all personnel who are so directed take cover within the skin of the ship. If your duty station is such that you cannot take cover within the skin of the ship, remember these following facts. I'm sure Cold knows this from his days in the Navy. Don't look directly at the bomb burst. Take cover behind some sturdy portion of the ship. Cover all exposed portions of your body. And of course, after the atom bomb burst, remain behind cover for at least 90 seconds, because after 90 seconds, the radiation should subside. Do not enter any contaminated area that is designated by this sign or indicated otherwise. And the sign looks like some weird little Grinch-like happy face. Do not eat, drink, or smoke during an atomic attack. And decontamination stations are provided for your protection. If you have been exposed to radioactivity, you will be directed to proceed to one of these stations for decontamination, which probably includes just putting a gun to your head and blowing you away. And finally, we all know how I love my favorite signs are when the signs are actually normal, but in combination, they provide a cute little message. Take a look at this one. This is a friend of Devlin's right here. That's right. If you want to see Denny's Hooters, go right there. And that is this week's episode of Crazy Signs with Drew Harcourt. I hope it gave you a laugh, because that's what it's all about.
Gorgeous. Well, that's about the end of the show, people. But before we go, we're going to rock your socks off again with Ham Sandwich.
Wait a second,
and as we do... No, Drew, I'm still talking. And as we do Ham Sandwich, people, we're going to give away the cash.
Okay.
So it's going to be amazing, people.
Stay in your seats. I was going to ask you if you forgot the cash giving away.
That's it, Drew. I haven't. Say, you're being a bitch.
Watch us fly into our praying positions. Make it happen, Swallow. Make it happen,
people. And while it's happening, people, Danny Dexing will be thinking about giving away 2K cash to somebody in the audience. Won't you, Danny Dexing? While the magic of Ham Sandwich happens, people.
The magic of Ham Sandwich. This day in history. 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 History.
That's right, people.
That's Paul's move right there. He added that.
I think Danny fell asleep.
Nope, he's typing. Styling, violent, living it up in the city. Got chucks on with Saint Laurent. Gotta kiss myself, I'm so pretty. I'm too hot. Call the police and the fireman. I'm too hot. Dragon wanna retire, man. I'm too hot. Say my name, you know who I am. I'm too hot. And my band bought that money. Break it down. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you.
Yay, Zachary!
Zachary Thomas Brennan Edison.
Brennan Edison. You mean because you're a Theo. Congratulations.
Oh, yes.
Zachary, not Zachary.
Oh, my God. Don't believe me, just watch. Don't believe me, just watch.
has another thing.
Now he's sitting on the Yay, congratulations! You'll be paying one. You're paying this one. Jackson, Mississippi. If we show up, we gon' show up. Dude, congratulations! I'm too high. A big yay for you. Police and the firemen, I'm too high.
Make a dragon wanna retire, man. I'm too high. I love the swallow a tumble.
And now, people, Devlin Kas will now give away another 2K cash. Take away Devlin.
I would like to know, what is the name of Tonto's horse?
That's right, people. In the Lone Ranger, what is Tonto's horse's name?
Oh, I thought you said Tom Doe. I was like, who the fuck is Tom Doe?
Oh my god, and Trigger. Shea has it at the top. It is
Shea. By the way, right now, my dog thinks I'm calling him Doobie.
Shea won it. Where is Shea? That's okay, Zachary. Where's Shea, Drew? Oh, this is at the end. Well done, Shea.
I'm gay. All women look the same. I'm the first member of Ham Sandwich to come out publicly.
What? Well done, Shea and Zachary. Yay, let's hear it for our two winners.
Perfect, Devlin. And now we must pray.